question. Okay, class. Today, we are going to learn about our friend, the semicolon. Does anyone know the benefits to using a semicolon? Anyone? Anyone?
Anyone?
The first benefit is that using semicolons adds variety to your writing. Instead of overusing periods and commas, you can use our friend, the semicolon. Does anyone know the second benefit? Anyone? Anyone?
Anyone?
The second benefit to using our friend, the semicolon, is that it helps avoid a lot of
pause,
cornucopia of short, choppy sentences by joining related thoughts. Does anyone know the third benefit? Anyone? And the last benefit to using our friend, the semicolon, is that it allows us to eliminate unnecessary words and write with more compression. And who doesn't love compression? Now, does anyone remember one of our number one rules of life that we can also apply to semicolon usage?
Use everything in moderation.
Wow. Good job, Gleason. He's right. I would recommend having at least 4 sentences in between each semicolon use, because the only thing in life that we should use excessively is water.
That's the clearest milk I've seen all day.
It's not milk. It's water.
You should probably stop using the same jokes.
I should probably stop using the same jokes. Is anyone concerned that my outfit's changed throughout this whole video? Grammar's just not that interesting. Besides drinking a plethora of water daily, there's 2 things I want you to take away from this video. 1, do 10 chin-ups every night. 2, semicolons must be used to join 2 complete and related thoughts.
Gleason, you're on a roll. Why don't you tell us the parts of a complete sentence?
1, it needs a subject. 2, it needs a verb. 3, must be a complete thought.
Now, a complete thought means it's independent.
I-N-D-E-P-E-N-D-E-N-T. Do you know what that means?
Yeah, it means it can stand alone by itself.
The second sentence here is actually a fragment. It makes no sense without the sentence that comes before it. It is dependent. Now your turn. Is the second sentence a complete independent thought? If you said no, you're right. Without the first sentence, the second sentence only leaves us with questions.
And remember, you should be able to replace your semicolon with a period, but you chose a semicolon because the ideas are too related not to use one. And please remember the difference. This is a colon, this is a semicolon. A colon, and a semicolon. A colon, and our friend, the semicolon.
L is for the way you look at me. O is for the only one I see. V is very, very extraordinary. E is even more than anyone that you adore. Can toi qui ne ma variant.
Is that it?
Can't see the semicolon.
Using 9
pas creux. Doch.
Sorry. I would recommend. I'll get it. Ready?
Take 75.
Yeah. It'd be funny if I took that one.
supposed to do it now.
Yeah.